One, how are you all? I hope that you all are watching all the lessons which we are teaching you, and you must be enjoying them and learning a lot of new things from all those lessons. But why are we teaching you? We are teaching you so that you gain more and more knowledge. And what is ma'am teaching you? Ma'am is teaching you English, and ma'am wants that you all should speak English fluently and also write it correctly, because whenever you are learning a new language, you should know all the basic things, all the small things about that language. That's so today's topic is do, does and did, and they are also helping verbs. Now we all know about nouns. What are nouns? The naming words, that is the names of persons, places, animals or things. Pronouns are the words which are used in place of the nouns. Verbs, as you know, that they are the action words and they tell us what somebody is doing. And we also know some of the helping verbs, that is, am, are, was, were, etc. Today, we are going to learn about three more helping verbs, and they are do, does and did. They can also be used as a main verb. But before that, let us look at the following table. Now, ma'am has divided it into two parts, the present tense and the past tense. In the present tense, let us see what ma'am has written. I, you, we, they and the plural nouns. So the helping verb do goes with all these. Then the helping verb does goes with he, she, it and all the singular nouns. Now do and does has a past form also. And the past form is did, did. And did goes with all these, that is I, you, we, they, plural nouns, he, she, it and the singular nouns. So now let us see once again, do goes with all these. So let us see how can it go. Say, see, I do, you do, we do, they do. Rohan and Rahul means two persons. So that is a plural noun. Plural noun. So Rohan and Rahul do. Similarly, does goes with all these. That is, he does, she does, it does, Rohan does. Now here Rohan is only one person. So it is a singular noun. So we are going to use does with it. So do is used with I, you, we, they and any plural noun. Does is used with he, she, it and the singular nouns. Even though I is singular, we use do with it. Okay. Do and does are used when we are talking about things in the present tense, means the things which are going on right now. That is, ma'am is teaching you right now. So this is present tense and you are learning and you are watching this video. So this is also present tense. Now did is used when we are talking about things in the past tense, means the things which we had already done. Jo cheeze hum kar chuke hain. For that we are going to use did, did. Did is used to replace both do and does, means for both do and does, for one single past tense helping verb we are going to use, and that is did. So did is used for replace both do and does in the past tense. So now let us see some of the examples which will make the concept of do, does and did more clear to you. Now let us see some examples. Do you have a pencil? So we are using do with you. He does not revise his lesson today. So with he, we are using does. They do a lot of work. He does nothing all day. Again with he, we are using does. He is singular noun. Sorry, singular pronoun, and we are using does with it. And they is plural. So more than one persons are there, then we say they. And we are using do or do with it. She does charity work when she has time. Okay, so again with she we are using does. Now he did a magic trick last night. So now it is past tense, last night. Okay, so we are using did. I did my homework yesterday. Again, you know yesterday means past, that is the day which has gone. So we are again using did with I. So with he also we use did, and with I also we are using did, because in the past tense only one helping verb is used. She did ballet after school last year. Ballet is a type of a dance form, and she did it last year. So we are using the past tense of it, that is did, did. Do you know one thing? That we can make questions also from do, does and did. And this is one of the most important use of do, does and did. Do, does and did are used to make questions. For example, we will take a simple sentence. You speak English. Now, if we want to change this sentence into a question, we will simply add do in front of it. In the beginning, we are going to add do, and at the last, we are going to add the question mark, and it will turn into a question. Now, as you know that you, with you, we are using do, do. So, the question will become, do you speak English? Question mark. Why a question mark? Because it is a question, so we will put a question mark after it. Now, if we want to say the same thing in the past tense, so did you speak English? Matlab, at some point of time, did you speak English? Now, next, he speaks Arabic. Now, with he, we are using does. To make it a question, we are going to add does to it. Does he speak Arabic? Now here speaks changes to speak. And if in past tense, did he speak Arabic? Next, you lived in Spain. Now to form its past tense, what will we use? Say, did you live in Spain? And lived changes to live. She lived in Japan. Now again, we are going to add did if we are going to change in past tense. Did she live in Japan? You know, we can make negative sentences also using do, did and does. But what are negative sentences? Whenever we don't want to do something, or we are not willing to do something, or when something we want to answer in no. So those sentences are called negative sentences, and let's see how we can make them. Do, does and did are also used to make negative sentences. For example, we take a simple sentence, I like ice cream. Now, to make it a negative sentence, we will add not along with the helping verb. That is, I do not like ice cream. Let us see next example. You sing very well. Now, if we want to say that the person doesn't sing well, what will we say? You do not sing very well. We can use the short forms of do not and does not. That is, do not changes to don't, does not changes to doesn't, did not changes to didn't. Like, I don't, he doesn't, I didn't, you don't, she doesn't, he didn't. Let us see some more examples. We go to South Korea every year. The negative sentence, we don't go to South Korea every year. They live in a big house. What will be the negative for this? They don't live in a big house. That is, this is wrong, that what you are saying. They don't live in a big house. He plays hockey. Now, one person is saying he plays hockey. The other is saying he doesn't play hockey. That piano looks old. That piano doesn't look old. She wants a new washing machine. She doesn't want a new washing machine. Now, if these sentences were in the past tense, then we would use didn't while making the negative sentence. For example, I didn't like ice cream when I was a kid. So, in the past tense, when I was a kid, I didn't like ice cream. You didn't sing very well at the party. So, the party is over now, and at the party, you didn't sing well. We didn't go to South Korea last year. Last year means the year which has gone. He didn't play hockey in college. So, while he was in college, in his learning days, he didn't play hockey. She didn't want a new washing machine. Now, we know how to make negative sentences and questions using do, does and did. If we want to give simple answers to these questions, then what will we do? Let's see. Do you speak English? So, we can give the answers either in yes or no. So, if we want to give the answer in yes, what will we say? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Do they eat meat? If they eat meat, they will say yes, they do. And if they don't, then no, they don't. Does he walk to school? Yes, he does. No, he doesn't. Does she work at Microsoft? If she works, then we will say yes, she does. And if she does not work, we will say no, she doesn't. We can use do or does for examples for emphasizing something, meaning that when we want to point or emphasize or to tell something, jab hume kuch batana hota hai zor dekar. For example, if you say I have a car, but your friend says you are lying, you are not telling the truth, you don't have a car, then to tell him the truth, to tell him that you are speaking the truth, you are saying something very true, you will say, I am not lying. I do have a car. I emphasize that I am having a car. I do have a car. Suppose Rohan works in an office and his boss asked him to send an email. And what does the boss say to Rohan? I told you to send me that email yesterday, but you didn't. When Rohan says, because he has sent, he will say, no, sir, I did send you the email. So, now to test your knowledge, we are going to do some exercises. Exercise 1, write do or does in the correct places. So, ma'am has written a few words. And you have to decide whether you have to write do or does in front of them. Number 1, he dash. So, with he, what we are going to use? We are going to use does with he. And similarly, you are going to do all the 10 exercise. Okay, all the 10 words. Alright. Now, we come to the next exercise. Exercise 2. Fill in the blanks with do, does or did. So, you are going to do this exercise also yourself. Ma'am is reading a few sentences for you. Number 1, dash, you want to play. With you, what we use? D-O, do. So, here we will write, do you want to play? Similarly, you are going to do all the other blanks. And then you will understand that what you have to add where. Okay? This. Now, exercise 3. answer the following questions using yes or no. So we have done this previously also, and one ma'am has done for you. Number one, do cats like dogs? Now, if you want to say yes, then you will say yes, they do. And if your answer is no, then you will say no, they don't. And now I have given a few more questions to you and you are going to answer them. And you are going to practice it with your brothers, with your sisters, with your mama and papa, so that you become fluent in speaking English also. Okay? So please do all these exercises. Bye.